Hello, so welcome. If you are looking for a strong, positive verbal communication in an interview, then possibly this is relevant for you all. Let's see what are the positive verbal communication and how it is to be used speaking, how it is as a speaking skills that will help you to present the best aspects of yourself in the context of the job for which you are applying. When combined with positive non-verbal communication, such as smiles, upright posture, and firm handshake, a job candidate can leave an excellent impression on the hiring managers with whom they are getting interviewed. In this particular shoot, let's understand all of it. Types of verbal communication for interviews could be the way you speak to the person who is interviewing. You will set the tone for how you are perceived throughout the interview. And if you get the position during your tenure at the company, here are some aspects of verbal communication that can help candidates present a positive impression during a job interview. Using appropriate pitch and volume. 1. Listening skills. 2. Responsiveness. 3. Being clear and concise. 4. Honesty. 5. Using humor. 6. Being polite. 7. Asking question. 8. So, if you have understood all of it, let's try and understand how we can improve upon these parameters. As simple as that. Using appropriate pitch and volume. Speaking tone and volume can help create a positive first impression. Maintain a medium volume. Always be medium volume. Medium volume. Not too harsh. Not too soft. At the same time, medium paced. Not loud enough to be perceived as irritating or arrogant. That's the boundary that you need to essentially not cross it. And not soft enough to be viewed as timid, shy, reserved. No, not required actually. A pleasantly pitched voice of medium volume can show an understanding of the situation and etiquette, professional etiquette, and will show that you are comfortable in your surroundings while respecting the gravity of the situation. 2, active listening skills. N number of times we have uttered, defined, and practiced too, but always remember, when we come across active listening skills, it is only to do with the intention and the purpose. To speak well, it is first important to listen well. Make sure you pay close attention to the words of the interviewer and stay focused on their words rather than on the room or noises coming from outside. Stay focused, whatever the interviewer is saying, have the direction. Unidirection, unifocus, and maybe both the ears concentrating on the interviewer as to what is coming next. You can show you are listening by nodding. The best way is, yes sir, yes sir, yes sir. Nodding, right. Smiling, yes, yes. Or by the use of words and phrases such as, I see, that's interesting. Or I'll definitely note that point, sir. Point noted, sir. You can also write any interesting points that you may want to refer to later. Maybe not only limiting to these words, there can be many. And over a period of time, you will definitely master them. So, the idea is very simple. Listening skill is also to be brought in your behavior, in your action, and make the interviewer believe that whatever has been followed is coherent, is incongruence to what it has been asked for as desired. 3, responsiveness. So good conversation will carry back and forth between interviewer and interviewee. It's a dialogue, not a monologue. So if the interviewer makes a suggestion that shows that they may want you to interject, do so even if the sentence wasn't phrased as a question. If the interviewer pauses, then take your cue and pick up the thread of conversation. For example, If the hiring manager says, your last work experience seems to be an unusual choice for you. So the candidate can possibly approach answering this particular question saying, yes, it was the first time I had worked for a museum or a large research facility such as this Bangalore Aquarium and Research Center. As you can see from my resume, my previous work experience had always been with the pet stores, but I had always enjoyed the educational aspect of my job and thought I would find more of that at the museum. While I did greatly enjoy my time cleaning the tanks, I missed the interactions with the customers, particularly with children looking to buy their first pet. I learned a great deal about the care of aquatic life at the research center, and now I am happy to pass the knowledge along to my customers approaching my museum. This could be a very, very good response. In terms of response, try to balance of your learning to what it will fetch. In fact, all the time your work has to reach its action. So apply your knowledge to where it should be ideally applied, and it can be easily explainable. Next is being clear and concise. Keep your answers to the point. Be clear and direct with your questions and your answers both. Even if you are asked a question that encourages an in-depth response, aim to express yourself with the fewest words you can. For example, if the hiring manager asks you, it seems like you only stayed at a play area supervisor job for 4 months. That's a pretty short time, especially compared to all your other jobs. Can you tell me what happened here? So the candidate can possibly answer it this way. Sure, I took the job while I was looking for assistant teaching positions. One suddenly opened up at a preschool, very close to my home. My supervisor at the play area was understanding, and I filled in on weekends and evenings until he was able to find my replacement. Honesty. Next, be honest about your strengths and weaknesses, but discuss how you are trying to improve. This strategy can provide a clear understanding of what you are capable of and what you may need additional training on when you are hired. For example, if the hiring manager asks, I see that you have always worked the sales floor before, but this job we are interviewing you for is more of a backroom position. If you won't be out with the customers, you will be restocking shelves and bringing sizes to the sales team. Are you comfortable with that? You can possibly answer this. I really enjoy customer interaction and the back and forth of helping them find the perfect pair of shoes. I would love to do that again. But I also love shoes, and I don't mind spending my time surrounding by them in the back room. I have always hoped to work at this particular company, and if I have to start in the stock room, I will do my best at it. Using humor. Humor serves many purposes, such as putting people at ease, reducing tension, allowing people to make connections, and cheering people up. It also acts as a bridge in allowing someone to bypass formalities to get to know you better. Using light humor during an interview can be a helpful form of verbal communication. But mind that word, light humor. But it should be done very, very sparingly. Humor in an interview should pertain to matters at hand. It is also wise to take the hiring manager's lead when it comes to using humor. Take them into confidence. If they start joking with you, you can also follow with a light-hearted sentence or two. However, if the interviewer presents a more serious approach, time to change the gear altogether. It is wise to follow and be as serious as the interviewer is. Next is being polite. Good manners are always a wise policy to use. Use greetings when you arrive and when you leave, and introduce yourself to everyone in the room if there is more than one interviewer. Remember, ladies first. So, good morning, ma'am, and good afternoon, sir. Accept water or coffee if it is being served to everyone, but decline if you are offered, but no one else is drinking anything. So if it is only asked to you, thank you, sir. Apologize if you accidentally interrupt someone while speaking. Generally, you should do and acknowledge other statements. Yes. I'm listening, sir. Go ahead, sir. Please. When you leave, make sure you thank everyone in the room for their time and consideration. Example may be when you arrive, you can say, good morning. Thank you so much for this particular opportunity. Hello, I'm Manish. It's nice to meet you. During the interview, pardon the interruption. I'm sorry, please continue. After the interview, thank you for this particular opportunity. I appreciate your time. I look forward to speaking with you again soon. And if you are asking question, if you are allowed to do so, ask question to the interviewer. Doing this not only will help you collect more information about your potential employer, but it will also show your genuine interest. For example, I understand that your company takes part in volunteer activities regularly. When is your next volunteer project and what charity are you working with? Or maybe earlier you mentioned opportunities to create a larger social media presence for the company. Is that something you are planning to outsource, or is it something that you could be added to this position? So mind you, next time if you come across this question, answer it very, very confidently. Because verbal communication for interview has to be very crisp and clear. You know for sure that the world is full of communication. No job is minus communication. So you need to be best prepared. I hope you've got this point. Best wishes. Thank you.